Lawyers of Reddit, what's the most laughable? I am not a lawyer, but claim you've ever read. I'm a lawyer in the US, and for some reason people are obsessed with common law marriage. I see people on Reddit and even hear the Myril warning other people about how you've lived with her for more than X years. You're common law married, so you have to take that into account. Or well, we've been living in the same apartment together for X years, so we're common law married now. And nbsp, common law marriage is only a thing that can be done in a small handful of US states now, and there are requirements to it. You have to hold yourself out as being married, live together, present yourselves to the world as being married, etc. You're not going to wake up one day and accidentally be common law married. And nbsp, eta, guys. I never claimed to be talking about the law in Canada or Australia. I'm aware that it's different in those places. I once saw a defendant argue for a not guilty verdict because there was no MR or MRS Commonwealth who testified. Obviously the charges were Commonwealth v. defendant. He doesn't understand that. He was found guilty. The judge did not appreciate that. When I was a judicial intern, I saw an arraignment where the defendant claimed the court had no power over her because she was a sovereign citizen who did not recognize the federal or state governments. Later learned that her sole source of income was Social Security. My favorite was on advice for home invasion. According to the poster, you could shoot or kill anyone who comes in uninvited. Absolutely not the case. Because self-defense by definition requires reasonable force. It's more lenient in some states and even more lenient in rural areas. But it's just irresponsible to spread this kind of misinformation. Edit. For anyone saying anything along the lines of nut up, you can always use lethal force if a nut up in this state. No. That's not what the law says. Anywhere. Reasonable force is an intentionally vague concept. And it's always interpreted case by case. Just because a defendant felt threatened doesn't mean a majority of the jury in his case would. Even if this is usually the case. Stand your ground laws. Castle doctrine. They exist to support defensive use of force. But you're always bound by reasonable force. And oftentimes, reasonable force can be lethal. But the judge and jury are the people who will decide whether or not you were justified. A group of people who may not share your same views put themselves in your shoes and decide if you did the right thing. The jury decides. Not you. Not your sheriff. Not your CCW instructor. If you're on trial for the use of force for self-defense, you absolutely shouldn't feel smug about it. The law has an unpleasant habit of surprising everyone. Stop making blanket statements about the law. If the law was black and white, we wouldn't need attorneys at all. As a lawyer, I love seeing all of the Facebook posts telling Facebook what they do and do not consent to. It's the online equivalent of Michael Scott declaring bankruptcy. I've found that Redditors are absolutely obsessed with correcting each other with the idea that assault and battery are often confused, and that assault only ever means to put someone in fear of imminent harm, to the point where if I even point out that that is only true sometimes, in some places, I will be downvoted. Roughly a third of states define assault as some version of purposely, knowingly or recklessly causes bodily injury to another. Anything on a legal advice? Do not go there for actual legal advice. I go there to laugh because come on. In real practice, though, we get those nutty proper plaintiffs suing for millions or billions because of some slight, or because the government doesn't have jurisdiction over them as free Americans, or because they're sovereign individuals. My favorite is if you ask an undercover officer if he is a police officer, he can't legally lie to you. Yes. Yes, he can. Had an undercover in on a deposition once and he had been wearing a wire for part of the investigation. He was asked if he was undercover by a co-defendant and his response was yay. Obviously. I'm here buying drugs from you guys cause I'm an undercover police officer. I have a wire hidden under my beard and everything, you ducking moron. He said it with such immense sarcasm they didn't think twice about it and sold him a trafficking amount of sugar. I browse our public freak out a lot and it never fails to make me laugh when people are being filmed throwing a tantrum and they start screaming about how it's illegal and they are going to call up their lawyer and sue them. Makes me think of this video from Wanda Schozen. In general, people arguing for an hour before realizing they live in different countries. I'm a recovering patent attorney who now works at a major research university doing work in autonomous vehicles, RT, and a number of other high-tech fields. The number of people who don't understand patents, particularly on Reddit, is astounding. And the number of people who comment as if they know what they are talking about is also unreal. I shouldn't be surprised by the comments alone because it's Reddit. But I'm the number of upvotes that follow are mind-boggling. I stop myself from submitting a response to those types of posts on a daily basis because it's just not worth my time. Also, almost everything analyzing Mueller, Trump, impeachment, etc., on our politics, our news, or any other subreddit is almost always incomplete or incorrect on the law. I had a non-lawyer try to tell me that testimony was not reliable evidence and that a judge could not rely upon it in making a factual determination. This was in the context of a small claims case I was helping my client prepare for. It was my client's word against the opposing parties, plus some photographs he was planning on introducing. I told the opposing party that I'll guess we'll see what the judge does. Spoiler, the judge found my client's testimony much more compelling and ruled in his favor. Copyright infringement. All you have to do is change three things. That's called a derivative work. Still copyright infringement. What you actually have to do is not copy. Most of these Askreddit threads asking questions of lawyers are just strings of comments from people saying I'm not a lawyer but, and then speculating wildly about the law. It's entertaining, but useless to actually getting the question answered. One of my clients was told by someone on the staff of the nursing home where her mother lives that if an enduring power of attorney, basically a power of attorney made in contemplation of future mental incapacity that unlike most powers of attorney does not become invalid if the donor becomes incapacitated, is voided if the original staples that held the pages together are removed. I can see a tiny grain of truth to this in that if the validity of the document was contested, the fact that it had been taken apart and stapled together again might be some evidence to support that, but there is no way that evidence alone would determine the issue. And don't even get me started about people who use the term hearsay but don't know what it means. This has become an epidemic. My answer is actually basically all of the I am not a lawyer, but claims. The funny thing about being a lawyer is that the answer is almost always it depends. Sure, the laws generally stay the same but the outcomes are so contingent upon the facts that you can never know with certainty how something will turn out. Thus, my answer for 90%+ of my clients is it depends on who the judge is, who shows up to testify, what the witnesses say, what theme opposing counsel goes with, etc. More importantly, we are not allowed to guarantee results and for good reason. The simple fact of the matter is judges, juries, prosecutors, and opposing counsel can make different decisions based on identical facts and laws. I think the only time I am not a lawyer, but would be appropriate is if someone is saying I am not a lawyer, but you need to consult with an attorney. Guy claimed he could lawyer himself because he played Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. I'm not a lawyer but I'm fairly certain that I could frame a dog for murder. The sovereign citizen stuff is my favorite. The United States is a corporation and the law of the seas applies. Just look at the fringe on that flag. I do not consent to jurisdiction. Runner up is you can't show me any law that requires me to pay federal income tax. This wasn't online. But a guy was representing himself pro se against a client of the legal clinic I worked at the time. She had a semi-public job doing promotion for a local pro sports team. Some dude did a brief fan interview with her at a game. And that lone interaction sparked a 5-year stalking saga, during which she got married and had kids with someone else, that culminated in the stalker making the following claim. He wanted a paternity test for her children, because he was convinced she had paid someone to follow him, find out when he masturbates, break into his home, steal his semen, and deliver it back to her. Apparently she had then impregnated herself with his Kleenex semen and her two small children were actually his. I've never seen a judge look as shocked, or as tired, as I did on the day that motion for paternity was denied. I once had a person claim that within there was no such thing as the adversarial system and that we were just trying to inflame a contested divorce. Should mention we live in a common law system and both parties had retained separate counsel. I work a lot in real estate law and I generally enjoy reading anything that comes up related to landlord-tenant laws. Generally speaking, Reddit loves to jump on the illegal and don't pay bandwagon. These are terrible pieces of advice. I have seen plenty of people recommend solutions that would likely result in eviction. I usually hop in, politely inform the poster that laws vary from state to state and that OP should review local LL tenant laws. Much of the misinformed garbage non-lawyers spew on the legal advice subreddit qualifies. My favorite. The judge cannot determine this matter because he is a member of the Freemasons. And the Freemasons do not believe in the concept of private property. This case ended with the non-lawyer accusing everyone of being a Freemason. The same non-lawyer also ran an appeal in that case based on the fact that the judge was not a real judge. Because the judge had not taken his oath of office. The non-lawyer had dug up a transcript of the judge's swearing in ceremony which read Judge Smith takes oath of office. When the judge took his oath, instead of the actual words of the oath, the non-lawyer referred to outdated and repealed laws from 1730, which said all oaths had to be transcribed word for word, as a basis for the fact that the judge was not a real judge. If his interpretation was correct, I think no current judge in Australia is a real judge. Absolutely the best e-mail arguments I saw on Reddit came during the Deflategate scandal in the NFL. For those who do not know, Tom Brady, the superstar quarterback for the very successful New England Patriots, was found to have deflated footballs in violation of league rules. That's kind of a minor thing, but it was against one of the best players in the league's history, and Brady fought it like crazy. The issue resulted in litigation in the Southern District of New York and, later, the 2D Circuit Court of Appeals. Patriots fans vociferously defended Brady and, frankly, I would expect nothing less. But some of the legal arguments Patriots fans would make were astounding. It was some time ago, so I do not recall specifics. But it was as if every Patriots fan on Reddit suddenly got a law degree and had years of experience practicing law. What I do remember, though, was their fans would often rehash the legal arguments Brady's very talented attorneys made in court filings as if they were gospel. But attorneys are paid to be persuasive. Everything we write seems compelling at first blush. But even if we write it authoritatively, it could certainly be wrong and lose. And that's ultimately what happened to Brady. Although, credits to his attorneys, he had some success at the trial court level, which was mind-boggling to me. The 2D circuit corrected that. There seems to be a general misunderstanding that testimony is not evidence. For example, I see this a lot in abuse cases. People will say the victim has no evidence, that it's just a he said she said. What a witness says on the stand is evidence. It's just up to the trier of fact to decide whether it's credible evidence. A tale from back in my public defendering days. Sovereign citizens are a special kind of stupid. Percentage wise, I don't know how many of them are true believers and how many think they've just found some clever loophole or another. At any rate, they were always the most interesting clients. One of them was a young gent who decided to represent another buddy of his to spin his nonsense to the judge. Unfortunately, the fellow who would become my client was a regular defendant in that same courtroom OSS and everyone there knew he wasn't a lawyer. When he was arrested OSS, which is to say immediate alias OSS, judge was not swayed by his argument that he was acting of counsel rather than practicing law without a license. The operating a motor vehicle charge which would follow was only semi-related. Literally anyone who claims to be an expert on the law who obviously don't know it. Like they've seen a couple of police procedural TV shows where they heard Miranda rights and they think they're now qualified to argue a case before the Supreme Court. Where I run into this personally is whenever I'm throwing someone out of the hospital where I worked. I have a right to be here. No, you have the right to seek medical attention. If you're just a visitor and you're here to steal meds and pick fist fights, you're out the door. Asshole. I'm in real estate. Over the last year or two, I've seen a lot of people try to quote the law as if they're lawyers. No, Karen. Misinterpreting your lease contract and the law supporting it does not mean you get to do whatever you want. Mitigate damages is not a get out of jail free card. Sovereign citizens. That is all. Not a lawyer, but I do own a tie. Everything related to Trump, impeachment, etc. that you see parroted from news headlines has no basis in jurisprudence. It's usually wishful thinking or giant corporations trying to change the narrative. Don't hold your breath. My two favorites are when people talk about the McDonald's coffee case as an example of greedy plaintiffs taking advantage of the system, or conversely, when they say X company has an army of lawyers on staff to fight the case. I'm not a lawyer, but I know that Citizens United made it legal to give briefcases of cash directly to politicians for their personal use. Many years ago, asshole former judge owned a company that owed my employer, I was controller, a bunch of money. He signed a security agreement for their receivables, meaning we could collect the company's receivables to recover our debt. The only problem was one of his employees was a friend of my boss and brought in a copy of exactly the same agreement, but with another company, dated a month before. Now, being a CPA candidate, I was studying business law and said, well, this looks like fraud and we can sue his ass for the entire company. My boss calls our attorney, who hated the judge with a passion, and related the situation. Yep, fraud. We went to court, got summary judgment. The judge just laughed at the crooked judge, and we owned the company. It was fun. It took me so long to realize ENL means I'm not a lawyer and not something sexual. I'm, legally, but I quit, a corporate lawyer. Basically no one understands fair use and copyright. I keep seeing people analyzing songs and art and calling everything plagiarism and copyright infringement. I'm not talking songs, but stuff like chord progressions or character names. Just because something exists within a work doesn't make it the author's exclusive property. Met someone who said they knew everything about the law and was studying to be a lawyer. Turns out she was temping as a paralegal for the better part of a week. This random guy at the deli told me, I'm not a lawyer but I know for a fact my baby mama ain't gonna get a dime of this child support money. I asked him why he thought that and he said it was because she owed back taxes with the IRS and they were going to garnish the child support payments to pay it off. All I responded with was, wow, that's new. Charlie, says the guy who knows nothing about the law. Dennis, I can absolutely keep a hummingbird as a pet. Bro, it's no different than having a parrot or a parakeet. It's a bird. Bro, Charlie, you really can't. And I'm not saying I agree with it. It's just that bird law in this country. It's not governed by reason. Dennis, there's no such thing as bird law. Charlie, yes, there is. Dennis, you know what? I'm going to get a hummingbird and I'll show you. Charlie, hummingbirds. Hummingbirds are illegal tender. Dennis, I'm going to get one. Charlie, you cannot. Dennis, to spite you, I'm going to get one. Mac, where are we with gulls? Charlie, you can keep a gull as a pet, but you don't want to live with a seabird. Okay, cause the noise level alone on those things. Have you ever heard a gull up close? It's going to blast your eardrums out, dude. 99% of posts on @agaladvis, any one of the posts is a gem of terrible legal advice. I'm not sure how to get the attention of someone who owes me money. Do you think it's a good idea to make a public Facebook post where I inform the public about how they are in debt to me and refuse to pay back my money? I'm not a lawyer but I think that's the best way to get their attention. You're right. It's also the best way to be sued for defamation. There's so many, mostly statements about the First Amendment. Since that only applies to government action, not private action. I would say I also see a lot of claims on how it's unfair to discriminate against X where X is not a protected class, or partially protected class. There are not as many protected classes or they are far more limited than people think. So if someone spontaneously decides to deny you service at a restaurant and it's not for a clearly enumerated reason relating to a protected class, you most likely do not have a claim against them. You can sue them but a judge will laugh you out of court. On a more practical matter, people also tend to very overinflate how much certain industries will be shaken up by recent legislation or appointees. People clients sometimes assume that everything is going to change all at once. Yes, things do change. But like, the SEC is not going to stop enforcing securities regulation anytime soon. Sarbanes-Oxley is not going anywhere fast. Our tales from the law. I'll just leave this here. Just today, a semi-retired police officer told us if you get pulled over while DUI, just chug an open liquor bottle in front of the officer. He claimed they can't prove anything then. Obviously, I didn't have the life experience to call bullet, and I'm sure a super expensive and super connected lawyer could get it down to open container. But I'm almost positive any half-ass lawyer could easily prove you were drunk. Alcohol isn't instantaneous. Yellow fringe flag theory. Had a criminal defendant demand I use this in their defense. No. F no. It is a warped, bizarre melange of admiralty law, constitutional law, army regulations, and some other junk that can be summarized as if the courtroom flag has yellow fringe on it. You are not constitutional, because you are now a military court without justification for martial law, and therefore, you have to let me walk. BTW. Most courts where I am at have yellow fringe on their flags as a common design theme. I can't help but laugh on relationship support posts that involve a cheating spouse. Without fail, there are people telling OP to document every single shred of evidence of infidelity. I do not, nor would I ever, discourage people from excessive documenting, because the opposite problem is much worse. But screenshots of your soon-to-be ex-husband's spicy DMs are next to worthless in divorce proceedings almost everywhere. If someone touches your car, it's technically assault and you're allowed to run them over in self-defense. Don't worry, you're protected under parody law. I am not a lawyer, but I know quite a bit about bird law. I'm not a lawyer, but I did stay at a Holiday Inn Express last night. I work for a courier service, and while we don't specialize in legal work, we still get quite a lot of requests. The best are the cooks trying to do proper work, non-lawyers trying to represent themselves, are 99.9% of the time completely insane. One time I referred a proper cook to a different legal service and 20 minutes later got a call from that service laughing, telling me to not send them any more crazies. Hey people, if you are working with the law, get a ducking lawyer. Obligatory. I'm not a lawyer, but my co-worker is, and I ask him some real damage that I should know but I'm not confident about. So probably literally anything I ask him qualifies. I'm not a lawyer, but we're legally allowed to go if the teacher doesn't show up after 15 minutes. Totally not a response to the question, but one of my most memorable cases. When I was a baby lawyer doing insurance defense, a woman was late on her premium payment and left a check with her broker right at close on a Friday. Broker just put it in a drawer BC she wanted to go home. Insured got into an accident the next day, and when the complainant called the company, they told him the policy had been cancelled for non-payment. That man went bonkers and tracked down the insured and busted up her car windows and harassed her before being arrested. The policy info was updated Monday morning when the broker got back to the office, but the insured was so upset that she sued the company for $1 million. Every week that we didn't pay, she filed an amended complaint adding $1 million to the claim and adding whichever lawyer was unlucky enough to cross her as a defendant. By the time the case was over, I'd had to appear in court over a dozen times. The woman was asking for $1 billion and the judge said she'd rule by mail so no one had to face the insured again. This is not exactly on point, but my favorite are the signs on the back of gravel trucks that say something along the lines of "not responsible for broken windshields." As if you can simply release yourself from liability for negligence by saying "I'm not liable." Absolutely ridiculous. Mexican lawyer here. Had an argument with my dad about the ownership of an apartment my mom kept after the divorce. But I paid for it. That may be so, but you put it in my mom's name and legally agreed to let her keep it during the divorce proceedings. You even signed the judicial agreement that says so. Yeah, but I paid for it. I understand, but that's not how property works. If you put it in her name and didn't contest it in the divorce, it's hers. Double quote. I don't understand. If I paid for it, it's mine. That's how property works. I could have it back if I wanted. Spoilers, he could not. Not a lawyer, but one that's been annoying me lately is how so many on Reddit have latched onto single dual party consent and bring it up when it's not even remotely relevant. For example, I recorded a guy yelling threats at me in a public place. Should I call the police? Did you have his consent to record him? Or, I recorded my wife in the bathroom talking to her boyfriend on her cell phone. What state are you in? Some states you need both parties. I'm not infringing on the patent. I got it from Google Images, which is in the Creative Commons. Sadly, have heard this defense more than once. And yes, when they say a patent, they are usually infringing either a trademark or copyright. Usually people in the graphics design department. Also, fonts is a big one. Do we have a license for that font? Of course. I downloaded it from FR3E Fonts.ru. Why? Someone threatened to sue me personally in the store I worked at because I thought her daughter and her friends stole something. If you heard a boy yellow duck, they have a camera, and came from the back to see them all booking it out the door, you'd probably be a little suspicious too. She claimed that I traumatized and assaulted her daughter when all I did was have mall security stop them while I asked if they stole something. Apparently she had consulted some random person and said she had a dangerously good case. She also called the police on me, who ended up escorting her out, all the while she threatened to sue their police department. A funny one from my personal life. I'm a lawyer. My brother was selling a script to a network and hired an entertainment lawyer. I was talking about it with my brother and asked a few questions. He said, "I can't tell you. It's privileged." I had to explain that he can tell me. His lawyer can't. I'm not a lawyer, but I find I'm not a lawyer. But, claims funny when they make silly mistakes, haha. I wonder how many people in this thread just dropped the "I am not a lawyer, but," and just decided to post about some IG they rebonded it before.